Hello everyone, my name is Parth. I'm Resource Manager of Chao Foundation, which is an initiative of Stop Acid Attack campaign, which works for acid attack survivors all across India. So basically, I would make you acquainted with our mission. What we do is that we reach out to the acid attack survivors of the past all across India, and we find out in what way we can help them. But in our basic mission, we try to bring out sustainable models, entrepreneurial models for all those survivors out there in India. मतलब हम लोग इस तरह से एकदम करते हैं कि उनको exactly जो उनकी need है, मतलब उनको ground level पे उनकी घर की ज़रूरतें पूरे करने की बजाय, we make them learn how to earn themselves. We provide them skills and then we give them a model in which they can be employed. So let's see how social media helps us. These are the three main focus areas. We work on awareness, we work on reaching out to this acid attack survivors, and then we focus on empowerment. And all the three focus areas have different projects based on the social media. So there are a few listed, but due to short of time, I wouldn't go in details. In our major work plan, social media has a very integral part to play. We create a project, and then we create a buzz in the social media, which again inflicts other media channels, like print media, electronic media, etc. And then we can drive those traffic to this crowdsourcing campaigns. And then we move on to the implementation of the project, which brings us to the impact from the project. So these are our basic social media platforms that we use. Over here, you can see there's a new one, Pulton.in. ये क्या है भाई? Pulton.in is a very customized website that we launched for social volunteering other than Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Because on Facebook, you would find a general public domain, but to extract exact number of volunteers who can be connected from us virtually all across India, we have Pulton.in. And these are some figures. We have more than like 7 lakh followers all across the globe. These are national reach. And on this chart, you can see the highest peak of inflicting crowdsourcing from the social media comes from Facebook, then from the other channels, and then from our website. Then finally, you can see the implementation. Out of all the crowdsourcing, 59% of the amount that we generated from the crowdsourcing is gone for the campaign development, that is, on developing projects that directly benefit the women, and the other 41% directly benefits in their medical assistance and legal assistance wherever possible. So that is how we work. Thank you.
I think he deserves a pen drive. He actually finished his presentation within 3 minutes. Didn't have to short circuit.
Thank you.